Okay, so you two made up after Black BabyGate, and then you had to relive it when you saw the show. Did your friendship survive that reliving it?
You know, anytime you watch the show back, of course you're going to be irritated about things that you've already gotten past or whatever. I will say it irritated the hell out of me when you were sitting there talking to Kendra or whatever. You had to compare you having Riley to kids at an orphanage. And I was
like, what I meant was,
I ain't like that. I ain't like that at all.
I didn't mean anything by that. I just meant that I've had Riley for more than like a day. Like I've had your daughter for days at a time.
No,
and like
I understand
I'm good enough
that.
To take care of her. But,
when your friend said whatever she said about, and you held that little black baby, I could have jumped through the damn TV and choked the hell out of her. And I'm so serious about that.
Kendra doesn't know you, and she didn't know me. But
right,
my thing
but
was like, I'm good enough to
say that about her kids. And she held your little black baby. You know what I'm saying? Like,
no, right,
I can't believe she said that.
I think. You know, I was just trying to help her understand. Like, I had your daughter, the closest thing to you is your daughter, and I had her for more than like a day. You know, I had her for a period of time. And to think that I wouldn't go to an orphanage and take care of a baby or be there, that just kind of blew my mind. But, you know, I just, you know.
Now that you've seen what Kandi and Cynthia said, what do you think?
Cynthia doesn't know me from Adams to say anything like that. I mean, she said she can't see me there. With,
right.
You know,
I didn't say you wouldn't do it.
You know, right.
That was
and
my
she
opinion.
Did clarify
you have
that.
Your opinions about me, so
yeah.
We're good.
And you're right. You did say that. But for Kandi to agree, I mean, that's like pretty major. Like, who wouldn't want to go to an orphanage? I love children.
Hold on. Let's be real about the situation. You wouldn't have wanted to go on the trip. Anytime we do stuff together, you always come up with an excuse of why you have to leave early or quickly. You never want to take long flights, long periods.
Right, right, right.
Even she had to be talked into going on the trip because she didn't want to be around it. Hold on.
Go ahead.
I'm not going to cut you off. I'm saying you, at that time, because it was no communication really between y'all. You know good and well, even if you really hadn't had a baby, if you wouldn't have wanted to go on a trip, I don't think you would have even been as hyped about it if it wasn't brought to you in the way of saying
right.
You wouldn't hold black babies. Because
right.
It made
that's
it
the only
more
message
into a racial thing.
Right.
And so to me,
and
that's
why
when
I
it became
right.
overblown. And looking back at it, even Cynthia didn't mention the word black baby.
She said African baby. But let me go back. Let me say this to you, Kandi. As a woman, I want to apologize because you did not say out of your mouth the black baby, the African baby, whatever. You did not say that. And I told you, you did not say that. I apologize for that, for misinterpreting your words. However, when you agreed with Cynthia, I just felt some kind of way because I can't even imagine myself being at home and having to watch this on TV, and then you have to defend your character because
your
friend is jumping
in. You were right there. Why do you say something then if it bothered you?
Do you feel like you threw Kandi under the...
No, absolutely. Throwing somebody... Maybe you guys are using the wrong choice of words, but I told Kim with Kandi right there, and I misconstrued what she said. But Cynthia said it, but Kandi agreed. So if you're agreeing with something that somebody
said... I couldn't see it. We can be friends, but it doesn't necessarily mean that everything you do, I like it or don't like
absolutely,
it. You know
right.
What I'm saying? It doesn't
mean
that I don't like
you would go to an orphanage as something against my character.
In
like it's
when
not.
I listen to you guys say that, it sounds racist to say Kim's a white girl. She wouldn't be in South Africa. She wouldn't be in Africa, and she wouldn't be in an orphanage holding little black babies or holding little African babies
right.
Running out.
Right.
That to me sounds racist.
I did not see it as a racial comment. I did not see Sheree be upset about it.
I was not, we talked about it. What are you talking about?
At that time, as we were riding, I did not have any notion that you were, like, upset that she had made that statement.
Well, I made, okay, that she agreed.
Well, no, what I'm saying is, okay,
Lord.
If you had an issue with it, you could have took your friend, our friend Kandi, and said, Kandi, I really thought that was not right what you said about Kim. What did you mean by that?
I didn't feel like I had to say that. You thought it was right? Did you think it was a positive? You sat there in silence. So
yeah,
did you think it was a positive?
I didn't think
did you think it was coming from a positive?
It was laughter, and we weren't the only two people laughing.
Nene,
yeah.
Can you see Kim going to South Africa and going to an orphanage
no.
Out of curiosity? You can't. Why?
I just can't. Just like them, I just don't. As Kandi said earlier, I've been around Kim a few times. Kim would have made every excuse she could have to get on the airplane before she got there, where we were going to sleep at, who was going to pick us up. I just cannot see Kim being.
I don't like flying. That's the only thing I'll agree with what she said.
I just can't see it.
So it's not a racial thing necessarily, it's a Kim thing.
Well, I don't know what they meant by it because I wasn't with them. I'm just saying that, yeah, it's just more of a Kim thing for me.
Allison from Daniel, Wyoming said, Kandi, after Kim has not compensated you appropriately for your part in making Tardy for the Party, and now she's taken Sheree's word for what was said in Africa without even talking to you one-on-one to hear your side, do you really consider her a friend?
To me, from what I have known of Kim for the last couple of years, anytime something happens, she just blows up before she even thinks to break it all the way down. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I already knew me and her, we haven't been really communicating, we haven't really been talking. So it's just like, okay, if that's the first thing you hear, you automatically gonna think, oh, Kandi, you know, is dogging me out. Do you know what I'm saying?
By the way, where do things stand with the Tardy for the Party payment? Did you ever pay her back?
Oh, my God. We have to talk about Tardy for the Party one more time. Seriously. And really, that is why things have been intense like it is.
It just gets annoying.
So nothing has changed since the last reunion. She didn't pay you back, and you've agreed to move on.
Yeah, I already told her. I was just like, okay, you know what? That was a learning experience, but I feel like good things have come out of me working with her.
Right. Okay.